the next video about Market Muse and how you can use it. So you can check successfully that we have successfully got into the tool, and here is a sample content that Market Muse itself has dropped. Just as I selected a kind of query that I wanted to, but definitely I'm going to remove this from here because I'm going to show you by demonstrating that how this tool works. So let's go ahead. The very first thing that we'll check here is optimization. Now optimization is here because definitely we want to check. Now let's say anyone is ranking on any version of a content, right? Let's say you are learning digital marketing from Color Academy, and definitely you want to do let's say freelancing after that. So let's say you are searching best 5 digital marketing freelancing options after let's say after digital marketing course, or after digital marketing course completion, anything you are searching, right? Because you definitely want to get that kind of an article up there. So once you make a search, you will technically get to see there are a lot of contents appearing on the top of it, and you can see there are different contents coming up. And definitely one of the blogs that I have over here that is also coming up. So you can just get into this article. Now let's say you want to create a better content than me, or you want to create a better content than any of the other people who are here, you can what you have to do is you have to just copy this link. Okay, now once you copy this link, let this content get loaded. And once you copy this link, you have to drop that link to Market Muse. And once you drop that link to Market Muse, Market Muse will actually tell you that what are the good things this article has done, or even for me also it can help, like what I can improve to do better in the same niche. So let's go ahead and let's check. So this is the article that you get to see over here. Now once you get to have a look at it, let's say this is your article. Let's say I am doing this research on the first degree, right? So I'll consider myself as a content writer or as a blogger, and then what I will do is I'll make sure that I can improve my article. So I'll just drop the URL over here, and once I drop, I'll just write a keyword like freelance digital marketing, let's say. Okay, so once I write freelance digital marketing, you can also see the location that it's predominantly targeting is US over here. So you can click on this location, and you want any other countries to select, you can select that. Now here I'll just write run and fetch. Now once I run this query, you will get to see a lot of data been visible on the screen. And then therefore we will get to understand like how exactly we can improve the same article that's there in the screen. Technically it may take few seconds to do it, but you should like just hold up. Well, and here you can see the article has arrived. You will also get to see several data like what are the number of word count in this article, how much you should do to rank better, what is the average word count of most of the people. It's still working though. Yeah, here it's now coming up quite well. There are different other tools on Market Muse, tools like questions. So if you are running a query and you just want to know what are the different questions people are asking on that query, you can easily get hold of that. Although there is another tool called Answer the Public. So if you go to Answer the Public, that also helps you with the same. But by any chance, here also you can do the same thing. You can also check tools like Research, wherein you can check different other competitors' content. You can also check tools like Compete, where you can check the status of other articles of different websites or different blogs. Well, it's getting quite overwhelming now with the wait. Well, this should come up. Well, it has arrived. Now, if you just check the details, so here my average word count is 2614, wherein they are telling I should have at least 2770 and my target should be 2974. And at the same point of time, you can see the different other data, like here we have different keywords has to be used, like suggested I should use this keyword for 10 plus times, but I have only used 1 to 2 times. Digital marketing has to be 10 plus, for me it's 10 plus. Freelance digital marketer has to be 3 to 10. I have used it for 0 times, which is not really recommended. So to be very precise, like I can just go on and add that keyword over here. And I can get a better ranking actually, so I can optimize the keyword or the entire content better. Search engine has to be 3 to 10 and I have that. So for me, most of the keywords that needs to be used, I have used it seems. But yeah, definitely there is a hell lot of scope to improve. Like marketing professional, it has to be 1 to 2. I have hardly 1, so there is none. So new clients, it has to be 1 to 2, it's 0. Marketing plan, it's 0. So a lot of them actually needs to be improved. Similarly, this is just one way of checking it. And at the same way, if you just want to check compete, now you can get to see top ranking pages, right? And what are the scores? Now my content score is 35, which is not bad, and the average everyone that they have as a content score is only 30, wherein I should target for 40. Although guys, if you see, there are a lot of people who are not really who are not really having 45, right? They have 38, which is definitely a little higher than me. Some have 41 who are ranking, and yeah, this one is really having a lot of a score, which has a lot of words as well. It's 5310 words. It's quite an app tool, you know. It's really a great tool. So with the help of this tool, you can also understand, like, Google is literally focusing on the word count to a greater extent, right? So this really let you know what you should do with your content if you are really targeting someone, or if you are just willing to write a better content. You are within the suggested range for this topic. Now digital marketing, I'm doing quite well. Digital marketer, I need to include more of such keywords in this topic, and so on and so forth. Now if you go for questions, just click on question. Now questions, you can see about the keyword that you type, let's say freelance digital marketer. So being a digital marketing, this is the first query that usually comes up in my mind. So if you just write freelance digital marketer, so you will get a lot of questions. Like here it was like I think natural language generation, so you can see here different questions people are looking for, like what is natural language understanding, how is natural language generation used, what is natural language processing, and whatnot. There's a plethora of text which are actually questions that have appeared. And at the same point of time, you can filter the country over here for which country you want to target. Unfortunately, right now it doesn't have India, but so far my understanding goes that most of the people who are writing English content, or let's say writing in any other international language, which is predominantly English, and sometime it may be Spanish, or let's say French or Germany to a lot of times. So I think they will sooner add on our country, like India and stuff. But as most of the people write on English, so they have these 2-3 countries actually. Even all of these are dedicated to English itself, I think. And yeah, now let's run this query. And once you run this questions query, you will get to see that there are a lot of questions been appearing on the top of the screen, and definitely these are what people are searching. Now again, to tell you something about it, like these queries that you get to see, these are not like queries which have been hopping over the search engine for last 2 years, 3 years or something. These are actually live. So if you go for answer the public, What you have there is most of the cases, the kind of queries they do show you, it's on a recurring period, right? So it's been happening for quite some time. But here, if you see, it's like very live questions that have been asked, like it is very frequently updated. So if you are a kind of a writer who is into blogging as well and or writing for the client to grow the traffic ASAP, you can technically use these different questions to layer your blog or to cluster your blog actually. So you can see what does freelance digital marketer consultants do, how do you find clients as a digital marketing consultant. Well, so these are some amazing ideas, right, to create content. So I being a blogger, I have been creating content. So these are something like extremely quality topics for me. So now if you come back to compete, then you also get hold of a very potential tool. Same with research, so you can check different kind of research links, articles and whatnot with the help of this tool. So we shall wait for a little time. So you can see over here, compete. So again, a query is there, that is what is natural language, and a link is there. So who are ranking on the top, right? So it's showing different results who are ranking on the top. They are also showing the score. So this one is ranking this was ranking on the first place, and this is 45 of a score according to Market News. And if you just scroll down, they have further clustered it in a way like what is natural language generation and what they signify with the red color, what do they signify with blue color and whatnot. You can see like every kind of note that they really want you to keep, like if you are using natural language as a keyword, so related topic or a keyword, you should use this 3 to 10 times. So this is how it goes usually. So I hope you have understood how to use this tool. All the best to content creators, and I hope you have liked this video from Color Academy. Thank you.